practical example, especially in those days we used to have manual systems. So you really depend.
I have actually been working on Ventator for I think about 3-4 weeks now, and we are through the development part. So we are now at the stage where we have to put the product that will actually go into the hospital. That's the prototype, and that's the one that's going to be used on patients. So for that, we have to ensure that every component that goes into that equipment is now fine and properly calibrated of the right quality for use on human beings. So that kind of prototype that we are now working on. And the design is complete, so we're just putting it together. Once we are through with that, we will now go to the next phase of doing the mass production. You do mass production when you have tested the product, and the test means really applying it to a patient, following the protocols provided by the Ministry of Health, and also approved by WHO. So that's where we are. The development, in terms of development, we work very closely with the doctors. We work with the anesthetists. We have worked with the top people who use these equipments, ICU staff, ICU nurses. So they have given us a valuable input on what needs to, what is important when it comes to use of a ventilator. So that phase is complete. So the part that is a little difficult is getting all the different components that you require to put the final product together. And we are working on that. Any delay will come from getting some of those parts, because some of them have to come from outside the country. We look at a point in future where we can also make a lot of those parts here, but that takes time because we are doing this the first time. But that's something that we hope to also achieve in the coming months.
That it can work. Yes. It's going to work. Like now,